So let us see dynamic braking. So in case of our DC machines, we were just disconnecting the supply and adding a dynamic resistance in place of source. So that will make our back EMF as a source. Okay, that will become I equal to EB by R S plus R D. Okay, this is opposite direction to our initial current direction. This is opposite direction to the initial direction. Initially, the direction was like this. Okay, this is DC motor. This is DC supply. This is R. Okay, this is B. This is EB. So I will be like this. This is under motoring condition. I will be V minus EB by R S. So under dynamic braking, this source will be replaced with this dynamic resistance RD. Okay, the direction of current will now be reversed. EB will be the source of current, and the current will be opposite to the direction of initial current. That will be EB by RS into RD. So as current changes, our speed of the machine will also try to reverse. Okay, at the point of speed is zero, we are going to disconnect it. Okay, so this is about dynamic braking in DC machines. Now let us see what is the dynamic braking in AC machines. Okay. So we know that we apply three phase AC supply to our induction motor stator. Okay, that will induce a rotating magnetic field in the air gap. Okay, this is our rotating magnetic field in the air gap. This rotating magnetic field will cuts with the rotor conductors. So the rotating magnetic field will cuts with the rotor conductors, and there will be a rotor rotating magnetic field induced in the rotor itself. So this will also rotate at synchronous speed, and this will also rotate at synchronous speed. That means we have a rotating magnetic field in the air gap. Okay, so we have another rotating magnetic field in the rotor. Okay, this will rotate at speed of synchronous speed, and this will also rotate at speed of synchronous speed. Okay, this rotor rotating magnetic field will try to catch up with the stator rotating magnetic field. Okay, now let us see, in dynamic braking we are going to disconnect the stator from AC supply, and we are going to give a DC supply to our stator. Okay, one positive terminal to one phase, and two phase will be connect to one negative phase. Okay, now what will happen? Initially it was a rotating magnetic field. Due to the DC supply, now it will be unidirectional magnetic field. That means there will be no rotation in the magnetic field due to the DC supply. Okay, so as DC flux cuts with the rotor conductors, there will be unidirectional magnetic field produced in the rotor also. This is in the rotor, this is in the air gap. Okay, so this will stop the rotor to come to zero. That means because the rotor is rotating because of the rotating magnetic field interaction between air gap and rotor rotating magnetic field, now there is no interaction between them and there is no relative speed, so our rotor comes to stop. So our rotor comes to stop. Okay, this is nothing but dynamic braking. In regenerative braking, we are going to change the supply frequency. We are going to decrease the supply frequency so that the synchronous speed will reduce and machine will operate as a generator that will supply power to grid. Okay, so in braking we are going to interchange the two phases of the stator supply, so that will cause some fastest braking is plugging. Okay, so advantage of plugging are fastest, actually advantage are fastest braking. Okay, this can be used for flush, and it is these are the disadvantages are it impact electrical and mechanical components. Okay, the impact of electrical and mechanical components is high. That means there is a huge current flow in plugging mode that will produce much heat in the resistors, so that has to be reduced because of this plugging. So our plugging is used for very rare conditions. Okay, so this is about dynamic braking. Okay, this is about braking of machine.